So I was speaking with Oliver from Broadsword at Wargaming the other day, and we was both talking how we don't really find time to improve our painting standard. I'm doing this video because I've got to paint models for the website to show the base ready products with models on the bases. It's not something that we've got or I've had time to do yet. So I'm going to use this opportunity as a double barreled sort of opportunity to learn to paint better, plus also get some work done. These opportunities are very rare, and I'm always inspired by these other YouTubers like Miniac, Brushstroke, Midwinter Minis, Age of Squidmar, eBay Miniature Rescue, and this guy. Trying new things like the airbrush, sub-assemblies, even cleaning models sounds daft, but it's not something I usually do to this extent. I scrape up the bad ones, but the ones that are minimal I normally just leave. Now, sub-assemblies is something that if I can't see it, I don't bother painting. But I thought if I'm trying to push the boundaries, I should try sub-assembly. I'm still using simple priming. I'm using a very cheap can of matte black spray from a pound shop. But it's cheap, it gives you a really nice, flat, even coverage, which you don't need expensive cans to do that. It's just how you use the cans. Now, having nice tools for the job doesn't technically make you a better painter, but it does inspire you to try new things, and it really gets your itch for painting. And airbrushes.com sent me this for me to play with, and I must admit it's given me a lot more motivation to try new things to improve my painting. I've always been scared of painting black, yellow and red models. Using the airbrush, what I've decided to do was prime it black as you saw, and use a black grey from Vallejo over the top. Now it's a very, very dark grey. And what I've learned from watching all the painters mentioned earlier is if you want a good white, never paint white. If you want a good black, never paint black. And I've put this into practice. And the reason that I've gone with like a light grey over the black is I can still do the black lining, which it's not as noticeable as on like a yellow model, for example, but it makes a difference because you're not using a pure black model. And when you're lighting black, it does appear lighter. Now with yellow, I've always been scared. Every time I've applied it with a brush, I'd overbrush with like an Avalanche Sunset and I get an okay look. But however, it looks a very browny yellow and it's a lot darker than what I'd usually like. So from watching people even like Goober Town Hobbies and using like hot oranges as a base coat, this really made a difference because the yellow is very transparent, and mixing some of that yellow into the hot orange and building them layers up gives you a very nice look. Did go a bit over top with the yellow. I'd started adding yellow to the orange paint and then I finished with just the pure yellow to get a very bright finish. However, I think I just applied a bit too many coats of yellow and I did lose a lot of the orange look to the darker recessed areas. But I have learnt something new, and I do like the look of the orange and the yellow. About two-thirds of the way through, I should have stopped, but I was enjoying myself. Like I said, I want to keep pushing the boundaries and trying and just mixing paints in the airbrush. It's not something I usually do, and I think that's something I can take from watching Guy from Midwinter Minis videos. It's mixing a lot of colours on a palette or in the airbrush rather than just getting the next colour along. Now my least favourite colour is red, so I had a good look at the paints and I choose to use like a burnt browny red, a standard mid to dark red, and then a highlight of an orange. Looked at the colours a bit differently. Reds along most paint ranges, you don't get a lot of colour choice because it starts looking pink very quickly. Rather than trying to find a set of reds, I started mixing orange into red to get the highlight. And I really did like the finish on this. It did look very pinky and pale towards the end, but once I started adding the other colours to it, I really did like the look. Now, when you've airbrushed something, I'm terrified of making a mistake because recreating that gradual blending colour with a base colour is pretty scary. So it encourages you to be neat. Now, again, back to the tools for the job. I'm using some good brushes. Now, this can be achievable with any brush, but having a nice set of brushes with a nice point really does help you be neat. So when painting a crest like this, I'd normally just slap some colour on or dry brush a metallic over it in a wash. But I had to pick it out steadily because I didn't want to mess the work that I'd done with the airbrush. What I did find with using the thinner paints and using a very light blue-grey, with it being thin, it kept the details rather sharp. With the paint being really thin and the brushes having a really nice amount of bounce, I could cut in. I'm still not 100% neat at that. It still takes practice. It's not the tool that makes you better at it. It helps a little bit, but there's a lot of technique in being a very neat painter, and being able to sit and practice like this did help. It was very frustrating at times, and I felt like I'd spend 20 minutes on painting a shoulder pad the wrong colour because I've got to build up to a paler white on the colours for this Black Templar. And it felt like it took a very long time. But when I was finished and it was neat, I did feel a lot better about the paint job. Now, going in and doing the black lining over the black grey from Vallejo was awesome. I was a bit dubious about it because it did look really dark. But going in there with just the Nuln oil made a massive difference, and it's something that I will do from now on when I'm painting big flat surface areas like this on a Space Marine. Now, I'd normally use a black wash on something like a crest, but I'm going up from a white and I've used a blue grey to start with, so I used a blue wash. Now, putting the blue wash on just this crest, I spent quite a while. It was only a very small amount of wash. I placed it on, I was watching where it was pooling, I was sucking the paint off my brush, which I wouldn't advise, and then soaking more off higher areas to get the nice recessed shading that I wanted. And I must have spent 10-15 minutes just on a crest soaking wash up. Crazy, I'd never do that, but the finish and the feeling I got after do that was great. Now, the model that I was most scared about being neat on was the red, because it is very hard for me to recreate that look with a brush. I probably could with a bit of practice, but I was extra neat with this. And as you can see, I've even gone up in brush size on this one, because I'd developed like what I thought was a lot better skill with the littler brush, and I've started using a bigger brush. And to be fair, I prefer the point on this bigger brush. And what I will say about using a bigger brush, you cover more of an area and you can hold more paint. So it feels a lot quicker, and I must admit I'm an advocate of using just the biggest brush you've got with a decent point on for doing most work if it's possible with that size brush. Now, for edge highlighting, I'm going to show you how I did it on the yellow one for this. I'd usually just grab a brighter yellow and just go on and do it. However, from watching the other YouTubers and taking things on board, I just added a bit of ivory into the yellow. And I thought, let's try this. And this worked a lot nicer because you've got the original colour in that colour that you're using. And it's not something I've done. It's something so basic. It's something that I just overlooked because I've got that many paints. I just thought I'd get another colour. And blending and mixing your colours gives you a really nice finish. You're using your base colour mixed in with a lighter colour, and it just looks so much nicer. Average painted model based even to a basic standard just by dipping it in the base ready looks 1,000 times better. And the one thing that I do is when I get to a point on a model, it might not even be finished, but when I'm looking at it thinking it's missing something, I will base it because that adds another colour, another element to the model. And when you base it, you can sort of see where it's missing. So sometimes I'll even base the model before I've actually finished it, just to see what I need to do to finish the model. Now, with the yellow Space Marine, I was looking at it and thinking it's very clean. And with it being on a black base, yellow and black does look very well, but I wanted a nicer contrasting colour. So I went with Mars on yellow. I think that's quite an obvious choice. But using the Mars base ready, with it being pigmented, you can actually weather the bottom of the model with it as well. It's a dry, dusty environment, so we're putting some dry dust on around its legs. And the fact that it's already in the base ready and the pigment is very subtle. You can sort of brush it on there and get a very nice gradual blend. And I thought this really took the model up to a next level, but I haven't really done anything. And again, I was looking at the model thinking, what else could I do to it? I based it and then I did no more with that model. So just basing a model can really stop you from painting. I don't know if that's a good thing, but I just needed something and I based it and I was very happy with it from that point. Now, I'm very happy that I've done this video as it's a good reference point. And what I'm probably going to do is in another 3 months, I'll get another box of Space Marines and I'll try maybe the same three colours again, or I might even just do with three other colours that I'm uncomfortable with and try again. Try and push the boundaries. As you can see, that the edge highlighting's a bit of a mess. The white's a bit gritty. I need to learn how to paint white properly. But for me, these are some of the nicest Space Marines I've ever painted. And it was nice just to take the time to learn and develop new skills. To some people, that might be very basic, what I've done. But to me, I feel like I've broke a boundary. I know I can sit down and paint a Space Marine to a nicer standard if I put some time in. And I'm sure the more I practice this, the quicker and the better I'll get. The red needs a lot of work, but I'll try that again. If you've liked this video, guys, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. If you really want to support my channel, do check out my Base Ready products and any other products for all your terrain needs. And during this time and how things are, do check the links below, because we've got quite a lot of local shops and shops all over the UK and the world where you can support your shop by buying these products also. So check out the links and you should be able to find a shop near you that stocks or sells this stuff. So thanks for watching, guys. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you again for the next video. Love, love, love.